इकोनॉमिक्स यस्टरडे वी जस्ट मेड द डायग्राम ऑफ टोटल कॉस्ट, टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट, टोटल फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट. नाउ इट इज द टर्न ऑफ मार्जिनल कॉस्ट. मार्जिनल कॉस्ट दैट इज गिवन ऑन 6.10 पेज. मार्जिनल कॉस्ट डेफिनेशन दैट इज एडिशन टू टोटल कॉस्ट व्हेन वन और मोर यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट इज प्रोड्यूस. सो हेयर आई एम जस्ट गेटिंग स्ट्रेट वे टू द टेबल. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 इज द आउटपुट एंड देन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द मार्जिनल कॉस्ट. सो दिस इज द मार्जिनल कॉस्ट. First, you have to fix up the marginal cost. Then you have to calculate the total variable cost. Earlier also, I told you the same thing. First of all, marginal cost. Marginal cost is 6, 4, 5, 9, 11. Means, first you are decreasing the marginal cost. Then you are increasing the. Marginal cost is decreasing up to this point. And then after that, we have to increase the marginal cost. You can choose number of your own choice. Like you can say 5. Then you can take 3. Then you can take... In increasing order like 6, 12, 14, whatever you want to do. Fine, so this is a marginal cost. First you have to decide this. Then, with this decision you have to take this as total variable cost. Like first, that is 6 rupees. And for the second, that is 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. 15 plus 9, 24. 24 plus 11, 35. In this way you will get the total variable cost. Then, total fixed cost. Definitely total fixed cost is up to you. Here it is taken as 12 rupees, you can take 10 rupees or anything, but that should be constant at all level of output. And total cost you will get after adding up total variable cost and total fixed cost, like 12 plus 0, 12 plus 16, 12 plus 20, 22, 12 plus 15, 27, 12 plus 24, 36, 12 plus 35, 47. In this way you can calculate the, make this whole table. But now, as per the definition that is given, that changes in the total cost with change in output. Like there is change in total cost. What type of change occurred in total cost? 6. What type of change occurred in total variable cost? 6. They both having the same change. Because why they both have the same change? Because in total cost, basically this plus this, they both are added up. But this is constant. So change in total cost is just due to change in variable cost. Because total fixed cost is constant at all level of output. So now the next thing, 18 to 22 and the change is 4 rupees 4. Then changes 4 rupees 5, then 9, then changes 4 rupees 11. And the same change you will find out over there. Exactly the same. Exactly the same. Exactly the same. So, with the increase in output, change in total cost, that is marginal cost. So, this is a definition comes out from there. And you can show this definition through this calculation also. Like 18 minus 12. 22 minus 18, likewise 27 minus 22, 36 minus 27, 47 minus 36, likewise. Fine. And marginal cost can also, you can get through change in total variable cost with change in output. Same changes you will get, and in this particular table, you will find the same changes. So you will get the same changes, same marginal cost with the total cost and total variable cost both. And here's the formula. Total cost of nth unit minus total cost of nth minus 1 unit. So total cost of nth unit is there, suppose 1. So is equal to total unit of n minus 1. It means 1 minus 1, 0. So total cost of first unit minus total cost of 0th unit, you will get the total cost of marginal cost of first unit. Because here n is 1. But if you consider total nth unit as a second unit, so here you will put second. Now what you will put here? 1, 2 minus 1, 1, and here you will put 2. So marginal cost of second unit. For calculating the marginal cost of second unit, what you have to do? Total cost of deduct the total cost of first unit from the second. And for calculating marginal cost of third unit, deduct the total cost of second unit minus total cost of third. So this is the formula you can write. But this is not the appropriate formula. This formula can be appropriate only when there is increase in output with one unit. But the exactly what you, which formula you should use? You should use this formula. Change in total cost upon change in output. That is also given over there. Why I'm just following through your book? Because so that you can find out the matter in your book also, and you should go through your book. That is very much necessary for you. If you really want to write well, if you really want to express well, so change in total cost upon change in unit of output, that is the formula which you can use in any type of situation. Suppose here output 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is there, then this formula can be wonderfully done. But if the output is increasing like 0, then 10, then 20, then 18, then 20, then 25. So likewise, if there is a jump of more than one unit in the level of output, then definitely you should go for this formula. Likewise, the formula, some problem is given. The total cost of producing 2 units is 200 and total cost of producing 5 units is 350. Now there is a jump of 2 units. So in this case, it is very much necessary to use this formula. So this formula is very much appropriate in all the situation. So there is a change in total cost. Change in total cost means 350 minus 200, that is 150. That is 150. And then there is a jump of 3 units. So 150 is divided by 3, that you will get the 50 rupees as marginal cost of which unit? Marginal cost of third unit, fourth unit, fifth unit. For all the unit, you will get the marginal cost. This is the marginal cost of third unit, fourth unit, fifth unit. All these units, you will get the marginal cost 50. So what you have basically done, you have difference the, you just distribute the difference between the total cost among all the difference in unit of output. देखो 200 थी पहले, अब 350 हो गई, 150 का इंक्रीज हुआ. 150 रुपीज़ को तुमने क्या किया, यूनिट तीन यूनिट का जंप जो है उसमें डिवाइड कर दिया. तो हर यूनिट को कितना मिला, 50 50 50. इसका मतलब हर यूनिट का कंट्रीब्यूशन कितना हुआ कॉस्ट में, 50 50 50. तो थर्ड यूनिट की मान लो कॉस्ट भी 50 है, फोर्थ यूनिट की भी 50 है, और फिफ्थ यूनिट की भी 50 ही है यहाँ पर. फिफ्थ यूनिट की भी 50 है यहाँ पर. सो हियर इज़ द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज नॉट अफेक्टेड बाय फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट. मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज लिटरली नॉट अफेक्टेड बाय फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट, इट इज़ नो कंसर्न विद द फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट. देखो मार्जिनल कॉस्ट यहाँ पर कैलकुलेट किया है, फिक्स कॉस्ट का नाम भी नहीं लिया, टोटल कॉस्ट से निकालिए, टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट से निकालिए. तो मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज नॉट एट ऑल कंसर्न विद द फिक्स कॉस्ट. टोटल फिक्स कॉस्ट रिमेन चेंज विद द चेंज इन आउटपुट, बट मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ टोटल फिक्स कॉस्ट एंड इट इज ओनली अफेक्टेड बाय द टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. टू फॉर्मुलाज आर देयर, वन फॉर्मुला इज देयर TCN, टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ nth यूनिट माइनस टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ nth माइनस वन फर्स्ट यूनिट, दैट इज द फॉर्मुला ऑफ मार्जिनल कॉस्ट. टोटल कॉस्ट द फॉर्मुला, टोटल फिक्स कॉस्ट प्लस टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट, दिस इज द टोटल फिक्स कॉस्ट विच यू हैव कैलकुलेटेड बाय एडिंग अप टोटल फिक्स कॉस्ट एंड टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. And it is not concerned with the total, but marginal cost is not concerned with the total fixed cost because marginal cost show the change in total cost and that change is occurred due to total variable cost. Fine. So this formula can also you can use total variable cost of nth unit minus total variable cost of n minus 1 unit. But in the trend we used to write total cost, not total variable cost. Fine. And then in this way you can get the formula like if this is the simplify the formula from this way, derive the formula. You can say marginal cost, total fixed cost of nth unit plus total variable cost of nth unit minus, this is the formula they have used, total fixed cost of nth minus total total cost of nth minus 1. So after subtracting or solving all this, you will get that total fixed cost of nth unit minus total fixed cost of nth minus 1 unit, you will get 0 out of this, and total fixed cost of nth unit is equal to total fixed cost of nth minus first unit. This formula, this not to be asked because this just to simplify the things, and that you can write in this way also. Fine. This particular derivation you can skip because this is simply the, they can want to tell that marginal cost is not affected with total variable cost, that you can show with this particular lines also. No need to derive this formula. Now marginal cost, you have derived the marginal cost, and now for showing the marginal cost, on x axis you will show output and y axis you will show marginal cost. While drawing the making the marginal cost curve, marginal cost curve will be for 6, then second unit per 4, fifth, third unit per 5th, then likewise it will be like this U shape. MC is U shape, and it will starting from the letter down and then it will become U shape. So here you will write down the explanation of this diagram. That up to second unit marginal cost is falling, and after second unit marginal cost starts to rise, and it is due to law of variable proportion. Law of variable proportion, why? Because due to the first stage, that is increasing returns to factor, marginal cost, if you are talking about marginal production simultaneously over there, then marginal production is first of all increasing in the first stage. So this is the point where the first stage is going on, where marginal production is increasing and marginal cost is falling. पहली स्टेज में marginal production आपकी increasing होती है production function में, जब आप law of variable proportion करते हो, जो आपकी first stage होती है जिसका नाम है increasing returns to factor. लेकिन marginal cost first stage में क्या होती है, falling. Cost घटेगी और production बढ़ेगी, first stage फायदेमंद की है आपकी, ठीक है. Then second stage will come. Second stage में क्या होता है, उसका नाम क्या है, diminishing returns to factor. उसमें क्या होता है, marginal production starts to diminish. तो ये यहाँ पर increasing होती है और फिर diminish होनी start हो जाती है. Here marginal cost starts to rise. सेकेंड स्टेज में मार्जिनल प्रोडक्शन तो डिक्रीजिंग रेट से बढ़ती, डिक्रीजिंग होनी शुरू हो जाती है और मार्जिनल कॉस्ट राइज होनी स्टार्ट हो जाती है. इसके बाद थर्ड स्टेज में तो कॉस्ट के बारे में बात ही नहीं कर रहा, बिकॉज इकोनॉमिक्स ऑलवेज सजेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर नॉट टू एंटर द थर्ड स्टेज. तो इसलिए बस ये फर्स्ट सेकेंड स्टेज की बात कर रहा है, ठीक है. तो अब तुमसे पूछा जाएगा वाई मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज फॉलोइंग, दैट इज ड्यू टू फर्स्ट लॉ, फर्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ लॉ ऑफ वेरिएबल प्रोपोर्शन, वाई इट इज इंक्रीजिंग ड्यू टू सेकंड स्टेज ऑफ लॉ ऑफ वेरिएबल प्रोपोर्शन। फर्स्ट स्टेज में क्या होता है, मार्जिनल प्रोडक्शन इंक्रीज होती है, और सेकंड स्टेज में मार्जिनल प्रोडक्शन डिक्रीज होती है। और कॉस्ट के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से फर्स्ट स्टेज में मार्जिनल कॉस्ट डाउन होती है यानी कि डिक्रीज होती है, और सेकंड स्टेज में मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इंक्रीज होती है। फर्स्ट स्टेज है, सेकंड स्टेज है, पूछा जाएगा तो बताना, अदरवाइज नो नीड टू टेल। फाइन, हाँ जी। नाउ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन एवरेज कॉस्ट एंड मार्जिनल कॉस्ट। सो देयर इज, व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन एवरेज कॉस्ट एंड मार्जिनल कॉस्ट। फॉर दैट फर्स्ट यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट, यू हैव डन द डायग्राम ऑफ मार्जिनल कॉस्ट, देन यू हैव टू डन द डायग्राम ऑफ एवरेज कॉस्ट ऑल्सो।